Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. I was in Austin the other day working on a project, and I was in the 28th floor of a hotel. And I don't know if any of you have been to Austin, but 6th Street, I think, is the street where all the bars and the clubs and everything are, and lots of energy, right? So you got a lot of bands playing, a lot of drumming, a lot of low frequency energy. So my room was on the 28th floor, and it was on 4th Street, and most of the music and energy was coming from 6th Street. So you can see that if we give 10 foot of distance to each floor, approximately 280 feet, which is really a football field, you know, if you think about it. And then we had the two blocks different between 4th and 6th. So what do we got total? 500 foot of travel for low frequency energy. And this is, you know, kind of what you have to understand about low frequency energy. It goes on and on and on forever, right? I could still hear the kick drum in my room at midnight. Almost enough to keep me awake, but I managed to get to sleep. But that'll give you some idea of the distance this low frequency energy can travel. So, when you think about all of this, do you still want to guess at how to stop it? I don't think so. That's the problem. You don't want to do any guessing. Absolutely none with noise. How are you going to be able to stop it if the hotel didn't at 28 stories up and two streets over? You're not going to be able to. So you always have to design for frequency and amplitude. You always have to know what frequency and how strong the noise is. That's the most important part. And once you know that, then you can start going towards the design of the barrier that you're going to use to stop that, right? We're going to build a barrier between us and the sound. That's going to be the goal, the noise source. So it's frequency and amplitude dependent. Guessing with noise is foolish. I guess sometimes, and I guess wrong. So what chance do you have after me doing this for years and years during real estate development, acoustical product development? You don't, see? You're not going to be able to know the materials that you're going to need. You're not going to know how to construct those materials. And you're not going to know any of that if you guess. You have to measure frequency and amplitude of noise, and you have to do it over a time frame that makes statistical sense. Can't just do one day. What if it's a quiet day? What if Tuesday in the neighborhood in which you live is the quietest day, and that's the day you play your drums the loudest? Immediate problem. Okay? There's nothing worse. I can't tell you how many people call me and say, I did this, that, or the other for noise, and it didn't work. And 90% of the time, I have to tell them to tear it down and start over. I don't think I could say anything worse to these people than that. You know, it just blows the whole motivation out of the design and everything else. They spent all this time, money, and effort, and it didn't work. And unfortunately, in a lot of this barrier technology, you have to tear it down and start over. So don't guess with noise. Measure. We have programs that can assist you. We have apps. You download them on your phone. Follow our instructions. We even have an online data sheet. Make it easy to fill in the information right from the app. It takes about 15 seconds each day. Now, I think that's a small price to pay for a guaranteed structure against your noise. And I think this example here of, I don't think we need the E here, do we? 28-story bass. So this is how powerful low-frequency energy is. And most of this is kick drum. Right? So you can understand how powerful it is. And when you're fighting an enemy that strong, you can't guess, right? You just can't guess. 28 Storey Bass. I hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.